During these difficult months of COVID-19, I've been fortunate enough to spend time in one of the most glorious places in England, Kew Gardens. Every visit, I am, at least for a short while, able to slip away into the peace and tranquility of being in what feels like a small piece of heaven on earth. As a scientist, I love Kew also for another reason. It is one of the most biodiverse places in the world, with over 50,000 living plants collected over centuries by visionary explorers. And today, a huge team of scientists continue the important work, from voyages to discover and identify new species, to projects of conservation aimed at moderating the growing impacts of climate change and habitat loss. As an enthusiast of minority wine grapes, I greatly appreciate these endeavors, and it excites me immensely that my beloved Canary Islands offer a treasure trove of unique and little-known varieties that are today being recovered to produce outstanding wines. At Kew, my thoughts and feelings on this subject always peak when I enter the beautiful Palm House and breathe in the warm air, lush with the sweet scents of tropical fruits and flowers. I am immediately transported to another Garden of Eden, but one where low latitude, warm ocean mists, and an encircling amphitheater of volcanic rock eliminate the need for glass. El Golfo, or the Gulf of El Hierro, is one of the most beautiful places that I have ever known, and, as a bonus, a viticultural jewel of the Canary Islands. Let me take you there. This episode is tropical paradises and the conservation of minority wine grapes. For me, few wines encapsulate these features of Canary Islands viticulture better than Bodegas Viñatigo's Marmajuelo. Juan Jesus Mendez, founder and director of Bodegas Viñatigo, which is actually a winery in the northwest of Tenerife, has spent his life promoting the inherent qualities of the minority grape varieties of the Canarian archipelago. Many varieties have been recovered from the island of El Hierro, with shoots brought over to a Jardín de Variedades Canarias, a kind of Noah's Ark of viticulture, a plot that sits just adjacent to Viñatigo's winery itself. Marmajuelo, for many centuries, clung on to existence in El Golfo, but has now grown in sufficient quantities in northern Tenerife to elaborate 100% varietal wines. Viñatigo's was the first and is designed specifically to showcase the personality of this rare grape variety. I've previously tried the 2013, 2016, and 2018 vintages, and they stood out to me for their richness of texture and aromatic potency. But today we have the 2017, which I've never tried before, so I'm very interested to see how it presents itself. Okay, let's get stuck in by checking out the color first. A very nice, deep yellow color. Almost perhaps verging on a touch of gold. And the nose. Really potent, really exotic. Straight away, I'm getting notes of sweet tropical fruits, plenty of pineapple, definitely pineapple, some banana as well, and maybe a little papaya in there. Really, really lovely nose. And it has a kind of warmth to it as well, almost a humidity. Quite interesting. Let's have a sip. The aromatics coming through really strongly on the palate as well. But this wine has a really lovely body to it, which I think is partly to do with the nature of the grape, Marmajuelo, but also probably something to do with the vinification method. So I know that a fraction of this wine was fermented in stainless steel vats, so that helps to bring out and enhance the primary aromatic, so those tropical notes. But a fraction of this wine also was fermented in these really interesting egg-shaped concrete tanks on their leaves, the vinification process that helps to enhance the body and texture of this wine. Let's have another sip. Really nice. I think the winemakers have done a really great job with this wine. There's the richness of texture and the infusion of the sweet tropical fruits, but also there's a really nice balancing acidity, almost a tartness, similar to, say, passion fruit. To me, all in all, I'd say this wine comes across as a kind of delicious tropical nectar, or at least the wine equivalent of that. If you're wondering what foods might pair with this wine, in my book, The Epic Wines of the Canary Islands, my Michelin caliber sommelier friend, Rodrigo, suggests to try this wine with fruit-based dishes with a seafaring character. And he suggests specifically avocados stuffed with prawns and pineapples from El Hierro. Speaking of the book, of course, remember that you can put yourself in with a chance to win a signed hardback copy simply by leaving a comment or question via the canary.wine website form. I want to thank everybody for the comments and questions so far. This week I'll address a question from KTW. So Katie asks me, do I only drink wines from the Canary Islands? And if not, do I have any other favorite wine regions in the world? So first of all, I drink plenty of wine from other parts of the world, actually probably much more than I do Canarian wines. Off the top of my head, in the past month, for example, I've had several wines from France, from Italy, from mainland Spain, from Austria, and further afield, Argentina, South Africa, and at least a couple of wines from Canada as well. Do I have a favorite wine region outside of the Canary Islands? I would say yes, I do. I think what I better say, first of all, is that it's important to note that most wine regions of the world are capable of producing really outstanding wines in terms of their quality. But for me, the wines that I always seem to enjoy the best are from places where, over the course of my life, I've developed something of a connection with the people and the land. Because for me, wine is more than just a sensory experience. It's an emotional one as well. So the example I'd probably pick out first is the northeast of Italy. So over the past 20 years, I've been part of a sports club here in the UK, a sports club that's twinned with another club in Turin. So over the years, I've spent plenty of time over there, and I've fallen in love with the people, with the landscape, and of course with the wines of Piemonte. I'll also say that I love the wines from Bordeaux. Of course, they are world famous for their fantastic quality. But for me, there's the personal connection because almost every summer I spend a good deal of family time on a stretch of coast that overlooks the Gironde River out towards the Medoc. I'll also mention Ontario as one of my favorite wine regions in the world. I know many of you have been interested in why I have the accent that I do. Well, I have lived most of my life here in the UK, but I was born and raised in southwestern Ontario, very close to the Canadian wine appellations of Lake Erie, North Shore, and Niagara. Maybe at some point in the future, I will put together a video on the fantastic ice wines of Canada. But for now, I think I'll continue to focus on wines that always remind me of the perpetual warmth and lush beauty of the Fortunate Islands. See you next time.